high hat you. It's time for a very important quiz, guys. This has been handcrafted by Star Wars superfans. You two are going head to head, no pressure. Let's hope the smartest force is with you. The room are pretending to be silent, but they're laughing loads in their minds. Right, Hayden, are you ready? You're up first.
I think so.
What is the one thing Anakin Skywalker is famous for not liking?
That's an easy one. It's coarse, it's rough, it gets everywhere. Sand.
Sand. Yes. I also hate sand. Hate it in my feet. Makes me gag. Do you like sand?
I don't have any feelings about it, really.
Ewan McGregor is ambivalent to sand.
I'm ambivalent about sand. Yep.
Ewan, it's your go.
Okay.
Now, I think you're going to get this. What Shakespeare play was Star Wars based on? Ooh. So it's based on this play, but obviously it's set on the moon, not set as Shakespeare intended it. So Star Wars is based on a Shakespeare play, and I'm about to teach you.
I don't think it is.
It is, according to Google.
No, Google. I don't think it's true.
Much Ado About Nothing.
No, it's not.
That's what Google said,
it's
and my
totally
producer
not.
Told me too. So you're getting fired if that's not true.
It's not true.
Okay, Ewan McGregor says it's not true, but yeah. If it is true, I have taught you something today.
Yeah, but I can't even see how it could be. I don't think you shouldn't believe everything we read on Google, I think, probably.
Oh. Now yeah. You've ruined my whole existence.
No, I know, but still.
All right, finish the line. Hayden, back to you. It's over. I have the higher ground. I've just said the whole line.
Well, that is the line. I was gonna
say. My God, now I've...
Isn't it high ground?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've got the high ground.
I've got the higher ground, I thought you said.
I think it's high ground.
Yeah, now I'm just... This is the worst quiz of all time. Yeah. Right, moving on. Finish the line again. You can buzz in. Either of you can finish this. Only a Sith deals in what?
Absolutes.
Boom. Ewan.
Thanks.
I think you got that as well, Hayden.
I think that's the first Star Wars question of its kind that I've ever got right, so I'm feeling quite happy.
You nailed it.
I'm usually a bit like, huh?
Well, you got the Much Ado About Nothing one right as well, because I was wrong.
You were wrong.
So you nailed that one as well. Yeah. I'll give you this one to you, Hayden. Where is Jabba the Hutt's palace located?
Oh, that's like they've just done that in the
if you look
Boba
at
Fett series.
Ewan's arms, that'll give you a tip.
Oh, Tatooine.
Yes!
I was gonna get there eventually. I didn't really need the help. I was just sort of thinking through all the options and possibilities. But yeah, Tatooine.
If you were gonna get a tattoo, would you get a Star Wars tattoo?
Get an Obi-Wan.
Yeah, get magic.
Get a little Obi-Wan Kenobi.
If you were going to get one, where would you get it?
This.
The arm's a good spot, yeah.
Maybe
yeah.
Episode 2 with the mullet, the mullet one. That'd be nice.
Just two lightsabers crossed with a little
That's metaphorical, I love it.
Yeah.
Ewan, what is Baby Yoda from Mandalorian's real name?
Grogu.
There you go.
Nailed it.
Yeah, I like Mandalorian a lot.
Good.
I really do, yeah.
And also, I feel really powerful knowing the real name, even though it's not that big of a deal because everyone knows it. But it
yeah.
Seems...
I think it was clever what they did. We all thought it was actually Yoda, didn't we?
Yeah.
And of course it's not. It was a very clever sort of misdirect. And yeah, Grogu. My little boy loves Grogu. He's only 10 months old, but he really loves him, you know.
Same with my daughter, yeah.
I was going to say, I think daddies know the real name because all their kids love them. But also, grown adults want Grogu's in their house. Like, I bought one for my sister-in-law. She's 36.
Yeah.
They love it. Tiebreak question, guys. This is a bit of a panic one. So it's fastest person to the...
Are we all tied up? Yeah? Okay.
Ready?
Okay.
Fastest to spell Princess Leia, go.
With the princess part, just Leia.
No.
Yeah.
P-R-I-N-C-E-S-S-L. Am I already off?
No, keep going.
L-E-H-A. L-E-I-A. No, there's no H. L-E-I-A. Huh?
Correct!
Yeah! Nice one!
Hayden, you win.
I only know that.
Spelling, a spelling question on camera. What a nightmare.
Because I got it wrong in the past.
Also, I just love the fact that I added princess in there, even though that's
I know, weird. Like, yeah. Even spelling princess on camera is a little bit stressful.
Well, you're welcome for the weirdest, hardest, most ridiculous quiz of all time. Obi-Wan Kenobi is back for a brand new Disney Plus series out May 27th. Very exciting to be back together, like, 17 years later.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Yeah.
You're like a walking 10-year challenge. What was it like to be back on set with each other?
That was really great. Sorry.
No, go ahead.
No, please.
Literally finished each other's sentences.
It was just too cool. I mean, being back on set, seeing Ewan again for the first time as Obi-Wan Kenobi was a surreal experience.
It was like the last 17 years this didn't happen, didn't it? It was very peculiar.
Is it? Do you keep in touch when you act together on shows? Because it's like, it's difficult. You do a lot of films, movies, TV shows. Did you keep in touch in the meantime, or was it like the first time seeing each other for...
We hadn't seen each other for a long time. I mean, we had kept in touch, and then I guess just logistically, you know, Hayden lives in Canada, between Canada and America, and we just hadn't seen each other for a long time, so we hadn't been in touch a lot. And then we bumped into each other, and I think when we met, bumped into each other, I think we talked about this maybe happening, but I didn't know what the story was going to be or who was going to be in it or anything. So we didn't talk about doing it together because I didn't know if that was what was going to happen. And then when the storyline did involve Vader and Hayden agreed to come back to play Vader, then we met up and we had a great walk. It was during lockdown. We met up in Santa Monica in this park and we were walking along with our masks on and sort of catching up on the last 10 years of our lives.
And you were practicing your Darth Vader with your mask on, obviously, getting into character, right?
Obviously.
Star Wars is such an iconic franchise. You've impacted the lives of so many people growing up, including me. Slightly deeply traumatizing for me because I did actually have a crush on Darth Maul.
Oh.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Really weird. Yeah. I'm now gay. None of it makes any sense.
Right.
But how does it feel to have had such an amazing impact on so many young people that have kind of grown up together? And now these people are going to be watching the show alongside the younger generations.
Yeah. But that's really nice. One of the nice things that's happened is that I can speak personally, sort of heard the reaction from the people that we made the films for, the younger generation of that time. And we didn't really hear that voice when they came out, you know. It was before social media or whatever. And sort of the reaction to the shows wasn't hugely positive from the critics. I was left with that sort of feeling that they weren't very liked. And then over the last, you know, 10 or so years, I've started meeting people who really loved them.
I loved them.
Yeah. But when they came out, they were it didn't feel that they were very well received, you know. Because I think the critics wanted to feel like they did when they saw the original ones when they were kids. And you can't feel that way
it's
again,
about
you know.
The fans, not the critics.
Yeah, I know. But now, you see, now we have there's much more interaction with the actual fans through because people have a voice now. Where
well,
they didn't
now
before.
The critics are the fans. So that's the exciting thing. The fans have become the critics.
They're the ones
doing the TikToks and like...
You're right, yeah, exactly.
Hayden, as Darth Vader, you're breathing alone. Sends chills down my spine. But I also do sometimes feel... especially when I'm watching the old film, like, that you're about to jump into a beatbox when it's, you know what I mean? Because it's like, like, was that a vibe? Like, has that ever been an energy?
He's got a beatbox button on his chest.
And that would be funny.
Did you ever click it? Yeah, like, how would that sound, like, the beatbox button?
I'm sure you could do it much better than I.
Well, what if I
spit
a beat?
Go on, give it a go.
Okay, ready?
Will you do the breathing and let her do it?
Yeah. Hi-hat. This is embarrassing for me, but I'm spitting some beats. It's Hayden Ewan in the Obi-Wan room. That's all I've got. That was awful.
That was it.